to pull over here and get on my camcorder just so I could show you this amazing sky this morning. This was the storm that went by, just missed us. I mean, look at this. Absolutely gorgeous here. And we'll just continue on here. Oh, there goes my neighbor. That's the guy I was parked to. He drives the motorhome and his wife drives the pickup truck with the ship, their boat in the back.
What the shell is going on?
Now that is one big giant shell. Look at the size of that thing, man. It's huge. It's taller than me. Beautiful bright morning here in Florida Keys still. I'm on my way to my next harvest host, about 40 minutes away, and it's the midpoint of the 2.5 hour drive from the mainland down to Key West. So it's at a restaurant, Hideaway Café, and to stay there you have to have a meal, which is fine. It's fine dining too, so I look forward to that. She's a famous chef, apparently, the woman owns it. So, but look at this. I just stopped here to take the picture, video of the shell, and then I wanted to show you this waterfall. It's a really cool waterfall, man-made, but it's really neat. So the pool guy here I was just talking to, they have a dolphin in here that you can swim with. I know that's usually really expensive. I'm gonna check on the way back home. Or on the way back home. On the way back up the Keys in a few days. And see if I can do that. The ignition for the motorhome has been turned on near the Theater of the Sea. That's right. GPS tracking. Can't beat that. Okay, let's go. Well, it's just about to show you the ocean, but here we go. The ocean is incredibly calm right now. It's not even windy, except for the wind coming through my window. It's as calm as a Canadian lake. Look at this. Pretty calm. This is beautiful, man. This is an absolutely beautiful, gorgeous drive down here. Seeing the ocean on both sides of me, and, oh my god. A lot of little small towns, a lot of beachside resorts. Man, I could easily live down here and just live on the beach and find a spot. Look how calm the ocean is. Okay, hold on. Here's a bridge coming up. I can show you better. Just around the corner here, I'm coming up to the first major long bridge in the Florida Keys. I've gone over some little short ones, just enough for boats to get under. But this is the first long one. I don't know, it's maybe half a mile long. Does it say the distance? It's channel number 5. It's channel number 1 in the Key West, or is it north of here? Look at the beautiful puffy clouds. Aren't they gorgeous? That was part of the storm as well on the southwest side. Look at this. Holy moly. So this Boondocker's welcome spot I'm going to, it's at, I think it's at the chef's house, which is about, I don't know, 5 minute walk from where her restaurant is. She's a chef. So I'm gonna go check, I'm early, so I'm gonna go check where I'm gonna be staying first. It looks like it's in like, you know, a subdivision of homes. And then I'm gonna drive over to the restaurant and check that out. But then I'll just park for a few hours because I'm really early.
Turn left on Freer Street.
Thank you.
Then turn right on Orange Avenue.
I can turn here. It's just around the corner. Let's go check it out. It's like a jungle in here. It's really cool, actually. The trees are like overgrown. Below you or above you and to the side. I haven't hit anything yet, but it's like just a real jungle like in here. It's really cool. But I went to the house. It's like her property. I don't see where she expects people to park in there, because there's just trees just hanging down. They're like maybe 8 feet above, just enough for it to get a car in there. Anyways, I'll go over to the restaurant. Maybe she wants us to park at her restaurant. But that wasn't on the Harvest Host as in the description. It was her home address. Anyways, let's go over to the restaurant and find out what's going on. What's up, people? So my Harvest Host didn't pan out as planned, but that's okay because I got something better. The restaurant I was supposed to stay at tonight, the lady took sick, and I really didn't want to go to her place, you know, and bother her and having to do all that. So she's the head chef at a little small resort here in the Keys in Marathon. She owns the restaurant up on the second floor where I'm going to go have dinner tonight. Sit on the balcony right over the ocean. So the gentleman here that owns this place knows the chef here and said, "You're more than welcome to stay here one night because of her being sick and all that." Nice guy. I didn't get to meet him, but the lady at the counter went and talked to him. So, I mean, wait till you see where I'm staying, guys. It's like, I love the Keys, man. I could easily move down here for permanently. I mean, it's not too hot and not too cold in the wintertime. It's just right. I mean, you know, it's been anywhere from 18 to 28 degrees most of December, January, and February. I looked up the history of the weather temperature. So, like, by Friday this week, even though I won't be here, or maybe I will, it's going to be 18 degrees day and night. So, but 28, these are Celsius temperatures. But this is where I'm staying. This is the motorhome.
Just park right there. Eddie really likes her spot. And this is my freaking view. Palm trees in my backyard. And so is the ocean. Yeah, I can't complain about this. It goes, "Oh, go ahead, relax outside and enjoy your day and I'll see you for dinner." Oh my God. I think the restaurant's already open and it's starting to fill up because I can smell the food. Yep, there's people out there eating already, up on the deck there. Right there, that's where I'm going up there. I have this wonderful view of the ocean. So the sun went down right there, behind the clouds, of course. And then in the morning, it'll raise over here. So that's directly east and that's directly west. So I'm looking directly south. The Keys aren't exactly... The Keys come down off the mainland,
and then they rotate, and they're almost parallel to the equator, pretty much. Maybe 10 degrees off the equator. So, nice breeze down here right now. I didn't even have to put my fans on anymore. I didn't have to put the air conditioner on, which I don't like anyways. I don't mind the heat at all. It doesn't bother me. Oh my God. Lady at the front desk said the chef that I was supposed to stay at her house, which is a block away, is amazing, amazing chef, and she's taught her other cooks who are going to be cooking for me tonight. She just said the food is fantastic. Now I'm going to try something here. I told you I got my little light here. Whoop, I think I did. I'm gonna turn this on and see how that changes my picture. So I'm kind of in the trees here and it's getting cloudy and gray out, so this is gonna be handy. And there's a new microphone on this. It's not the clip-on yet, I did buy that, but if this one picks up my sound better when I'm farther away or closer up, I'm just gonna keep this one and take the other one back. The Rodes, R-O-D-E-S, yeah. So I gotta get changed with my fancy attire, because it's a fine dining restaurant, so I don't want to look like a slob or a beach bum, t-shirts and a shorts, and go have dinner. I put my reservations are at 6 p.m. So stay there, eat dinner, and then just chill in the motorhome after, or even just go for a walk along the beach. Anyways, if you're about to have dinner, enjoy your meal. We'll talk to y'all later. Bye-bye. So I'm heading home for dinner. Got my nice, tacky tourist shirt on. I like this shirt. I've been told I look good in it. Got my Richie Sombrero hat on. I get so many compliments of this silly hat. I've had it for like freaking 40 years. Maybe not 40. How old am I? 38, 40, 50. 30 years, at least. But I'm gonna go over to the restaurant sooner. But I thought I'd walk you down along the beach here before I go in. It's nice and warm. Oh, man. I could handle going down here every day. In fact, I was just thinking about maybe asking the owner here if I could park here for five or 6 days and give him some money. But I would need electrical hookups because I can't do without electricity for 5 or 6 days. So we'll see what he says. He's a nice guy. I mean, who knows? If I give him the right amount of money, he just might go for it. But that's where I'm sitting up there. Oh, I better get going because it's getting full up there. This is where I'm going to be eating up here. This is the Highway Café. Okay, so I just had this amazing chicken at this restaurant here. It was incredible. And it was quite busy. It's like the only fine dining around in Marathon. So if you're in Marathon, make sure you come to the Hideaway Cafe for a nice cooked fine dining meal. It was delicious. And I get told that the steak's even better than the chicken. But it was good. I better get off this because people are already looking at me. Why the light blocking? Sorry to hear that. Okay. Just gonna turn? What's it doing? Uh-oh, now I've lost you. Where'd you go? Stupid. I don't see you though. Oh, there you are. Okay. So that was a lovely dinner I just had. The chicken was amazing. The, what's that salad called? The Caesar salad, which I haven't had in a long time, was delicious as well. Good pricing too. It wasn't as expensive as I thought it would be. With a steak or steak and lobster was $70 or something like that. Want to go for a walk on the beach? Let's go. I'm just in the underground here talking to Stan and Charlie Gray. Say hi, guys. Can you guys hear me?
We can hear you.
Say hi.
Hey, everybody.
Say hi. Say hi, everybody. Okay, where's the beach? Whoa. Okay, I can't see nothing on the beach now because all I see is this bright light in my face. See? On my new camera, or my new light on my camera. Okay, that's not bright enough. Hold on, I gotta turn it up. I gotta take the cover off. Okay, there you go. Now look how bright I am. I mean, I can't see where I'm walking because of this light shining in my face.
Stan, when do we get to tell them?
What? I can't see where... Where's my motorhome? I could walk into the ocean and not even know it. Oh, well.
Well, I hope you would know it.
I've had too many iced teas now. I feel buzzed.
At least the ocean's still wet. I don't know, maybe you wouldn't.
Okay, can you guys see the tree there? The palm tree?
Not yet?
See, all I think about right now is da 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 da.
Hold on, I got three brightnesses. Now can you see the palm tree?
Yes.
Okay.
And I keep thinking
of... Oh my lord, this bright light. Okay, and then it does a flashing, look at this thing. Now it does a flashing thing. Now it flashes. That's one setting.
All kinds of new toys.
Look, it looks like lightning. Okay, hold on. Oh my God. Sorry, folks who, okay, I'm gonna have to point this camera this way. I won't even be able to see where I'm going. Nope, I gotta turn it up though. Okay, this is gonna be the worst video I put on YouTube. There we go. What if I do this? I'll put the camera like this and then have me behind it. Oh, I lost you guys again. What? Go back. Okay, there's the motorhome. So Stan, I'm parked right in the ocean here. There's the motorhome.
Okay, let's make some very big statements. Do you know where high tide is?
Uh-oh, never thought of that. I don't know. Hey, I've turned my motorhome into a boat before. Why Stan all dark? I can't see him now.
Okay.
So I'm talking to Charlie Grayson. I'm talking to Stan from Ambulance Adventures, but I don't see him anymore. He's in the dark again. Anyway, okay, I'm gonna get in the motorhome and get on my laptop. I'll be right back. Mr. Libby Bob.
Okay, sorry folks. That was a fun walk back to the motorhome. And this light is insane. Okay there. That's a soft one. I'm gonna put this plastic cap on too. And see if that's better. Because it is. Right. Did I lose the cap? Oh, there it is. Okay, now put this cap on. And then it's like, this is not bright in my face. It might not be as bright, but okay, I can't even see the motorhome. Oh, there it is. This is happening in real time. Where's my keys? Right there in my pocket. Yeah, there's my pocket. Okay, I got the keys. Is it this one? No, is it that one? Frick, which one is it now? It's this one. I shouldn't be showing you which keys I used to open the motorhome with. In case somebody gets a hold of my keys, I'll know exactly what keys to use. Okay, don't look away. Okay, I won't show you. Stop it. Go that way. There's that one. I have three keys to open up this motorhome. Yeah, I know. People are thinking like, what? How could it be a third one? Nah, I'm not telling you. Okay, there's one in there. Where's the other key now? That with the deadbolt. Oh, are you kidding me? They're not that heavy. And there's just the door handle one. But then I have a secret one somewhere else. I have to look away. There's the third. Okay. I put a new gasket around the doors. So it's a bit stiff. Oh, it's dark in here. Hello? Honey, I'm home. That's my outside light. When I say honey, I'm home, it's usually because Solix is in here on the underground. Okay, there we go. Oh, Jesus, who put those shoes there? Okay, it's really hot in here. Okay, well, I'm gonna go. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And I'm gonna have some green tea and maybe some key lime pie from Naj. I think it was key lime pie. I'm gonna have to ask her what flavor that was again. And I'll put it down below in the description of the pie that Dash cooked for me. See y'all tomorrow morning when I leave for the Keys. When I leave in the morning for Key West. Woohoo! For 2 days. Goodbye. Love you. Miss you.
Okay, there's the motorhome. So Stan, I'm parked right in the ocean here. There's the motorhome.
Okay, let's make some very big statements. Do you know where high tide is?
Uh-oh. Never thought of that.
Yeah.